divide basically the subject into three different subjects. And those roundtables, don't forget, the previous year, 2008, we had all these hearings. Next year, 2009, we had all these roundtables. Again, get people, let them ask questions, let centers ask questions from experts. We call them, again, the host of fair, impartial experts to come and share their ideas with us. Again, centers do not pontificate, they just kind of really listen and ask more questions. One roundtable analyzed how we move from a system that pays for the quantity of care to one that pays for quality. I think this is the self-sleep healthcare. It's our business. People don't know much about it yet. They haven't figured it out yet. But when you explain how we pay, how we reimburse based on the basic quantity, not quality, and that is the root cause of a lot of the waste and inefficiency in our system, little lights start to go on a little bit. They're not quite sure exactly how it all works. But you can see a little pathway to it, some understanding here. And run round tables on that subject alone. But I do think over time that's going to be the real big performance for such a huge difference in America's healthcare system. Another round table focused on coverage. How do we make coverage more affordable? Reforming the health insurance industry and making service available to millions of Americans. The third round table focused on ensuring insurance reform is fiscally responsible. As we're providing coverage, we've got to make sure that we pay for it and pay for it in a very responsible way. That was the third roundtable. How do we do all that? Well, after investing time in the learning process, we sat down with staff and more experts began to walk through different options that we have options meetings. These meetings give community members an opportunity to learn about their proposals so they can start to talk more openly about their priorities, more confidently about their priorities. There's a lot of work. A lot of work is important. And while the Finance Committee was plumbing through all this, another committee, you just heard from Chairman Tom Harkin, the Health Committee, then chaired by Senator Dodd, was, had its own version of health care. We were very closely together. Again, I don't want to be too presumptuous about this, but I do think the white paper we earlier put out was to set the basis for almost all committees. The Health Committee did a lot of great work. Across the country, supporters like you are working hard too. Each of you should feel very proud of being part of critical legislation that will change the way Americans think about health care. Because of this law, families like David Hutchins and his son Elijah will not be discriminated against for denied coverage. Because of our shared success, health care coverage will no longer be something that too few families can afford. And because of this law, health care decisions made by doctors and patients instead of insurance companies. System of fair rules were replaced decades in insurance company abuses. Because of your advocacy, health care coverage will no longer be valued and paid for by the quantity of care, as I indicated. Instead, health care providers will be rewarded for providing quality care.